waiting for the rain, but it did not rain. And they hoped it would be rain. So when you also inquired, when you went to the city to inquire in the weather office, but then also you did not get any positive response. And while returning back, he was under the shape of a tree where he met an old woman and they started conversation. So let's see what happens next. But my son, that is what I'm talking about. You have strength now. You can go without a break. But have you thought about the land? The earth works too, where you blow and sow and plant. The earth has grown for years, centuries, in fact thousands of years. The soil, the land, the earth. Shouldn't someone let the land rest away? The old woman said, softly smiling. So when you said to the old lady that you work very hard till you get school, at that time the woman replied that
for the crop. Oh, my son, nature knows a thing or two.
earth. On the other hand, in such situation, the land is left alone because farmers don't till the land, they don't grow the land, they don't sow the seeds, and the land is left alone undisturbed. It is not disturbed by the farmers. And at that time, it lies undisturbed, staring at the sky and resting. So, in the land gives rest. After cultivation for many years, the soil loses its fertility. So here, nature, mother, knows when the land should have rest, and so that year it did not rain because the land needs rest. And when the rains come, it will spring back into activity, fresh and ready for the crop. So she says that when it will rain, again the land will be ready for activity. That is the activity of cultivating the crops and cultivating the crops. Oh, my son, nature knows nothing but to know, she said, and what not. So she suggested the farmer venue to go home. She said that Mother Nature knows everything, and so she suggested venue to go back home, and she got up from there. She walked away. After a while, venue too got up and walked home. He thought about the land, his beloved piece of land, which if he were to be named the old woman, was perhaps breathing peacefully, taking a break from the constant, ceaseless year-round cultivation. After some time, Bellu also got up from there and he also started to walk towards his home. So while walking, he thought about his land. And his the piece of land was very dear to Bellu because it gave him his livelihood. Now he started believing the old lady and thought that his land is resting peacefully. It is breathing peacefully. And it's taking a break from the constant, ceaseless year-round cultivation. Without stop. Or continuous. That his land is breathing peacefully, taking a break, taking rest from the continuous cultivation. Perhaps she is right, he thought as he approached the village. It was already evening, the sun was low in the sky. And what was that? When he felt a cool breeze on his back. Then he felt a funny drop on his shoulder. He looked up. Yes, the clouds were gathering in the distance. It was going dark. Soon there would be lightning and thunder and sweet, fragrant rain. When you ran home laughing and happy. So now, when you now thought that the old lady was right. As he went near the village, it was already evening. The sun was set. son was getting darker and darker. And now soon there will be lightning and thunder. It soon rained, because when you saw the clouds gathering in the sky. And you could also feel the fragrance of rain. When it rains for the first time, there is a fragrance in the atmosphere. So when it rains for the first time, there is a pleasant sweet smell. So he was sure now that he will have the fragrance of rain. So now the Venu was very happy and he started laughing. I hope